guys, Mr. Fresh presents 7 things toxic parents say to their children. Children should consistently anticipate their parents' adoration and care. Yet, imagine a scenario where you have toxic parents. Research shows that in excess of 50,000 kids were authoritatively considered survivors of emotional abuse. Whether abusive words are planned to cause torment or not, they can leave imprints and recollections for a short while to a lifetime. Terrible comments can come from friends and family like parents, and the mental and sentimental harm can hinder many people, particularly their children. The manner in which parents bring up their children and behaviors around them sets up the essential ground which assembles their character and confidence. So, how can you say whether a parent or guardian is toxic? Here are 7 things toxic parents say that can influence a child's life. Number 1. Oppressive or abusive words. For example, are you mad? Are you stupid? Useless. Parents should learn to stop using these abusive words on their children. Oppressive words can harm children's confidence. It is important that parents should energize their children into having confidence in themselves. Number 2. Void promise. Are you a parent that always say these to your children? If you do this, I will get you that, or I will take you there later. Yet then they don't do it. Making counterfeit promise is a great method to show a kid how not to confide in others throughout everyday life. At the point when a parent makes promise that they don't keep, it breaks the kid's trust. It causes the children to feel deceived. Number 3. Selfish wishes. Toxic parents make their children feel empty by using words like, I lament having you. I wish I had an early termination. I wish you were other child. I wish you were not born. These comments are so hurtful to a child and to every human at large. Parents should never say something like these to a kid. It would make them assume that they are not supposed to exist in this world in any case, and that they don't have the right to be alive. Such comments weaken a child's entire feeling of identity, which can prompt self-hurt and unhappy. All things considered, parents should make their children to feel cherished and esteemed. Number 4. Offensive words towards their appearance. Debasing a child dependent on their appearance will probably just build their actual weakness and stress over their self-perception. For example, you are monstrous. You are excessively fat. You are too short. You are excessively thin. Or you have appalling hair. These could prompt intense sentimental issues like mental problems. Parents should show their kids how to adore themselves regardless of how they look like outwardly. Number 5. Unhealthy comparisons. This will decrease a child's confidence considerably, and makes them imagine that they will never be good enough, regardless of how diligently they attempt. Likewise, comparing your child to others just advances an unfortunate connection between them. For example, for what reason are you not like your kin, cousin, or other children? Other children are more better than you. These will make them feel envy and disdain towards one another. Kin ought to be similarly given the option to assemble their own autonomous characters. Number 6. Causing the kid to feel like a burden or obstacle. In the event that a parent says these to their child, the kid will feel like an obstacle. It will make them unintentionally conceal their requirements, sentiments, and issues just to keep away from the fury of the parent. For example, you cost me an excessive amount of money. Having you depletes me. It is so difficult to care for you. It was reported earlier that absence of adoration and friendliness, or materialistic things are a portion of the foundations for certain kids to go into stealing, and being harmful. Number 7. Threatening abandonment. This will make a kid have desertion issues. Expecting that individuals they love will leave them in view of what their identity is. At the point when a kid grows up, this conviction will be unknowingly instilled in their mind. For example, I will abandon you. I will leave you aside. One day you will look for me but will not find me. I will simply vanish. These will cause a child not to believe future connections inspired by a paranoid fear of them leaving. Finally, despite the fact that words are not actually destructive, they could be incredibly unsafe to the mind and sentimental state of health. Youth is a fundamental part in each human's existence. Our youth assembles our characters, practices, and convictions. Have you encountered any of these types of abuse? What is your opinion about them? Let us know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe so that you won't miss out other interesting videos like this. Thanks for watching.